Hello, I'm Pete Gerlach. I'm the author of the nonprofit Break the Cycle website. Part of the cycle is ignorance. One of the things that I have learned in 31 years as a professional family systems therapist and as a keen observer after 73 years on the planet, part of the ignorance that gets transmitted down the generations has to do with parents not knowing key needs that their children need informed, patient, adult help with. This video, which is part of a group of videos from Lesson 6 on my website, Lesson 6 is about how to improve the effectiveness of your parenting. What I want to do here is summarize for you my conclusions after listening with compassion to well over 1,000 people, clients and students, talk about life problems, their own, their families, and their children's. I conclude a major unspoken problem in at least the United States, if not elsewhere, is ineffective parenting. My biased proposal is that almost all non-organic personal problems, relationship problems, family problems, parenting problems stem ultimately from ineffective parenting. And what is effective parenting? I propose that parenting is the art and science over 20-some years for a given child of knowing and effectively filling a child's developmental and special needs. Parenting is nurturing, which means filling needs. Effective parenting includes the parents filling their own needs while they're filling their children's needs. Logic says you can't fill a child's needs unless you know what they are. My compassionate view is many parents who absolutely love their children have never been taught by their parents or by our society some fundamental needs that the children don't know enough to ask for. I want you to put me to the test here, because I'm going to summarize vital, essential needs that minor children have that many parents who are busy and distracted and unaware don't know. If you're a parent, pause after each one of these and consider, did your parents give you this? Did they fill this need in you? And are you filling this need in your child or children or other young people in your life? By the way, notice I am not going to say the usual children need life skills, they need to learn how to balance a checkbook and drive a vehicle and buy groceries and manage their money. We all know that. I'm not debating that. I'm about to say some things that most parents are unaware of. See if you agree. The first and almost paramount need that children have that many parents are not filling is the need to be aware. Awareness is the key to personal health, personal security, relationship health, social health, problem solving, communication. Awareness is absolutely essential. Yet I am not seeing any evidence in our society by the media or my clients or students or anything that parents are teaching their kids how to be aware. There are 4 zones of awareness. Can you name them? If you can't, I hope you'll look at my video on a very simple, powerful exercise to build awareness that you can use yourself and model and teach to your children. That's the first need that kids have that no one speaks about. Another need is to steadily and patiently encourage the growth of spiritual wisdom, not religious, spiritual curiosity and wisdom, and encourage children to be curious about and grow clarity on what is their life purpose. They have special gifts. They also have limitations. They're on the planet to do something really useful and unique. Many parents, in my experience, don't pay any attention to this or very little attention. Therefore, their kids don't pay attention to it either. The third need, which almost universally parents are unaware of and don't fill in their children, is the need that minor kids have, without saying so, to understand and to harmonize the subselves that comprise their unique dynamic personality. I bet you've never heard that before. If this makes no sense to you, which is normal, I strongly encourage you to study the videos related to Lesson 1 here on YouTube, and then read the articles in Lesson 1. They are about the fact all normal, not pathological, normal personalities are composed of subcells. One of the subcells is your true self. If your true self leads your personality, your life goes much better than if other subcells do. Kids need parents to explain in age-appropriate terms, what is your personality, how is it composed, who are your subcells, who are the subcells that are leading you, and where is your true self? It's a complex subject. See the Lesson 1 videos to understand this and find out what it was your parents never taught you about this. A key thing that I'm sure you would agree with is kids need parents to help them learn how to earn and keep their own self-respect. It's the same thing as self-esteem. It's the same thing as non-egotistical pride. It's fundamental to being serene and happy in most relationships as the environment changes. Consciously, intentionally, fill the child's need. I need to learn how to respect myself, including my limits, my talents, and my purpose. Kids need parents to teach them how to be respectful of other people despite inevitable differences. A different way of saying that is kids need encouragement, guidance, to build tolerance for other people despite inevitable human differences. Fundamental child need. Here's a big one. My experience as a therapist suggests very few parents patiently encourage their children to identify their emotions, to see them all as useful, not positive or negative, useful, every one of them, and to be able to use their emotions as guideposts saying, this is what I need right now. My emotions are pointing out some need of mine I need to fill. All emotions are useful, not just some, all. Did your parents help you regard your emotions as useful and encourage you to feel and express them in safe ways? Did they do that? Are you doing that? Your kids need you to do that. In particular, the emotions that kids need help with is to learn how to differentiate anger from frustration. They feel the same, but they're different, and they point to different needs. Kids need to learn how to identify the roots of guilt and learn how to manage guilt. Did your parents teach you how to do that? Are you teaching your kids? See my video on how to make use of guilt. The last thing that kids need, among many, here I want to highlight, they need help learning how to accept the feeling of anxiety or worry, learn what it means, and learn how to act to reduce it. Okay? So kids need help accepting their emotions as useful and learn how to use them. A major need that, in my opinion, at least American parents are completely failing at, and so does our school system. Children need to learn how to communicate and problem solve both personally and socially, effectively. There are two conditions required for effective communication. Can you name them? There are seven communication skills, specific skills anyone can learn. Can you name them? If you can't, you're not modeling them, you're not teaching them, your kids are growing up ignorant of them. To learn what you need to teach your kids about effective thinking and communication, see Lesson 2 in my nonprofit website, and, for a preview, see the cluster of videos on YouTube about Lesson 2. Another major need that kids will never ask you to fill, what they really need, is to learn how to grieve. Throughout our lives, we form attachments, healthy people do, and our attachments are broken for various reasons. That causes losses, and we need to be able to grieve them in order to stay on track and live balanced lives. Kids need modeling. They need to see their parents grieve and other key adults, and they need to have an understanding. What is the process of bonding? What are the three levels of grief and the phases of each level? Most parents don't know this and don't teach their kids. Did your parents teach you? Can you name the three levels? I bet you can't. There's help. See Lesson 3 in my website. It's all about healthy grieving. And see the related YouTube videos for Lesson 3. It helps you learn what your kids need to learn from you. Another thing that kids need informed patient adult help with is learning how to identify and accept their limitations. I know I'll never be able to win an Olympic gold medal. I'll never play the accordion and gain world fame. I'll never fill in the blank. Kids need to understand and accept, with not whining or griping or complaining, but what they can do and what they cannot do, or cannot do well. They need to accept those things and focus on what they can do and learn to grow those things they can do, their skills and talents. They also need help from adults, and they need to watch their adults learn from their mistakes instead of shaming themselves and burdening themselves with guilt. They need to say, yes, I made a mistake, I don't like it. And parents can say, okay, what did you learn? What is it that you're going to do differently the next time? And then repeat that and repeat that and repeat that until the kids teach themselves how to learn from their inevitable mistakes. So I've just outlined nine complex, vital needs that minor kids have that they need their adults at home and at school to fill for them. They don't know these needs, and they don't have the language or the knowledge to ask for them. So it's up to the adults in their lives to fill these needs so that the kids can become functioning, self-sufficient young adults and effective parents themselves. They need to learn how to be aware, how to be empathic, how to grow spiritual wisdom, how to evolve clarity on their life purpose, how to understand and harmonize their personality themselves, how to keep self-confidence and self-respect, how to learn to be respectful of others despite differences, how to manage and use all their emotions, not just some, how to communicate and problem solve effectively, how to grieve well. Did your parents teach you these things? If not, you can learn them now by studying my website, Lessons 1 through 6, and the 100 related videos. I hope you'll invest in yourself and your kids in doing that. Thanks for watching.